Hello, I'm Shardul. Today we are going to learn how to add zoom and pan effects to screens while creating technical demonstration videos. This is an important skill to learn because our users will watch these videos on their iPads, iPhones, Android phones, and devices with really, really small screens. Let's get started. Let us take a simple case where a user would like to add an additional startup page to Google Chrome. Our demo shows the precise steps to do this. First, let us see what the demo looks like without the zoom and pan effect. Okay, next, let us watch the same sequence, but this time with the zoom and pan effects added to it using ActivePresenter. In the first part, we will see how to create a simple zoom. Our goal is to zoom in on a screen element, highlight the action being performed, and then zoom out. On the toolbar, click the Insert Zoom and Pan icon. The zoom and pan capture frame is displayed with a purple border. Drag the capture frame to the screen area that you would like to zoom into. Click the preview button. You will see that the virtual camera correctly zooms into the target area. Next, we will see how to zoom out. In the slides pane, create a copy of the first slide. This is slide 2. On the timeline, click the zoom and pan object. In the properties pane for this object, change both the start time and the duration to 0 milliseconds. The green diamond for the zoom and pan object is now at the start of the timeline. This ensures that slide 2 remains zoomed in at the exact location where slide 1 ended. Next, we add one more zoom and pan object to slide 2. I'm sure you recall how to do this. That's right. Just click on the zoom and pan icon in the toolbar. In the properties pane for this object, change the zoom scale to 100. By doing this, the virtual camera zooms out to the full screen size of 100%. And that's it. So, let us see what the result looks like. In the second part, let us see how to add vertical and horizontal pans to our screencasts. The first step is to create an anchor zoom frame for our slide. As shown earlier, add a zoom pan object to the slide. In the properties pane, change both the start time and the duration to to 0 milliseconds. Our anchor frame is now ready. Next, add one more zoom and pan object and drag it to the new location in the lower half of your screen. For a smooth pan, ensure that the left-hand edges of both captured frames are aligned vertically. That's it. Click the preview button and enjoy the smooth vertical pan. Lastly, let us add a horizontal pan to our screencast. Copy the second zoom and pan object from slide 1 and paste it into slide 2. Create an anchor frame from this object. Do you remember how? That's right. In the properties pane, change the start time and duration to 0 milliseconds. Next, add one more zoom and pan object and drag it to the new location on the left-hand side of your screen. Make sure that the top borders of both the capture frames are horizontally aligned. Click the preview button and enjoy the smooth horizontal pan.